You helped me. So, like, first of all, okay, you had DJ Premier and you had Joey Diaz.
I had Joey Diaz.
So wait, for anyone who's not in the know, Joey Diaz was officially retired from stand-up.
None of us could believe it, because if you guys, for those of you who don't know, I know a lot of people are well-versed in our kind of circle of comedy podcast friends, but like, you know, Joey, we all kind of, you know, kind of, we turn towards, if we're, you know, at the end of a night, what are we going to do? And everybody has an opinion. Then we look at Joey like, you know, you tell us, yeah. Right? Like, or like, what's the right answer to this thing? It's like, it's Joey. He's Uncle Joey, right?
Uncle Joey. My daughters literally call him Uncle Joey.
I mean, he's a little older than all of us. You know, he's got the wildest life experience.
He's got a video that's going viral every 5 minutes. All you need is 20 good fucking friends to take over a country.
Oh, he's got, got great, you know, perspective. He's out of his mind. But we all love the guy because he's so fucking hilarious. And during the pandemic, obviously we moved to Austin. He moves to like where he grew up back in Jersey, which everybody was like, huh? I mean, you kind of understood it. And then he starts doing his podcast there. And then, you know, stand-up was put on hold for all of us. And then we're talking to Joey and we're like, kind of after we're all kind of getting back on stage after a minute. It's like, what about you? And he's like, I'm done. We're like, what do you mean you're done? He's like, I'm done.
It's hard. You have to have that. There's got to be something that there's got to be something broken in you, because that break of stand up,
yeah,
a lot of people retired. A lot of people were like, I think I'm good.
Yeah.
And Joey was one of them. And I think Joey, what happened was they were here during the beginning of the pandemic.
Yeah.
And then he was like, I can't live in this box with this kid and these cats.
Yeah.
And my wife. Like, I need a yard. I need a life.
Yeah.
And so he went over to Jersey.
And also, LA got, fuck, is so weird.
LA sucks.
It's so weird.
I fucking hate that I live there.
It was a weird time. Like, that was, it honestly motivated, you know, my lifelong Angelino wife who would never leave LA to be like, yeah, you can leave LA. And I was like, really? And so anyway, he leaves. Every time I talk to him, every few weeks. It's, you know, it's usually a brief call, but he'll be like, done. Don't want to do it. I'm over it. Don't miss it. I'm like, what?
So I texted him. So we, obviously everyone by now should know this. We're recording this a week earlier. We've announced the Fully Loaded Festival. Mm-hmm. Fully Loaded Festival is a festival I came up with when the pandemic started, and I wanted to do at drive-in movie theaters.
Yeah.
Except for like all the best comics aren't working right now. Why don't we get them all on a bus and we'll all just do 10 minutes. We'll all just do 20 minutes and go around and tour in outdoor theaters. And I loved the drive-ins. I think drive-ins were a tad bit complicated. And I remember calling my agent and saying, you put me in an amphitheater and it's a game changer. Amphitheaters are legit comedy spaces.
Yeah.
And he was like, what if we create our own amphitheaters? Because all these minor league ballparks are kind of like struggling right now with, would you go in and do minor league ballparks? Put the stage on second base, fill the infield with fans, fill the stadium with fans, concessions, day drinking, sunset. And I was like, fucking deal. So we get this offer to do 8 shows.
It's just such a Bert description of a good time. Yeah.
Oh, dude, it's everything I love. Everything I love about an event. And it's not too much of a bite. It's 8 shows, right? Yeah, 8 shows. They're like, I'm not going to say, look, I'm not going to break it, hurt anyone's feelings. They're like, number one person you want on this show. White Whale. It's Dave Attell, right?
Obviously. Yeah.
First offer goes to Dave Attell. He accepts. And as soon as Attell accepts, I'm like, holy shit. I'm like, this just became real. I start listing off everyone I want. And one of the people I wanted was Joey Diaz. And I know that I didn't want to put him on the spot.
Yeah.
So I texted him. And I said, hey, man, I'm doing this festival. It's got, I want to say everyone's name to give everyone respects. I just said Attell. It's got Dave Attell, Fortune Feimster, Nikki Glaser, Mark Norman, Big J Okerson, Sal Vacano, and Taylor Tomlinson.
It's a great lineup.
The biggest selling comics in the country right now.
Solid.
And I said, I want to add you to it. And he was like, I wrote a long email. You know, Joey doesn't, or a long text. Joey doesn't read it. And he goes, thank you. That's all he writes back. I don't hear from him at all. The offer expires, obviously.
It's like, we talked. And you're like, we didn't talk.
And so I'm like, fuck, I don't know what to do. So I text him again. I was like, hey, man, I'm really excited. If you want to do it, I will make it work for you. And he goes, okay. Doesn't, no response.
Yeah.
And then you get him to do fucking stand up again.
Dude, so this is how, so he comes to the show. He brought Jim Florentine.
Yeah.
And my friend Sean. I go, what's Sean do? He's like, he's my jiu-jitsu instructor. Like, he said it like, how do you not know that?
My friend Sean.
I was like, okay. So they're backstage. I give him a, you know, I'm so happy to see him. I give him a big hug. And you know, he's rock. He's doing his Joey Rock where he's like this. And, and then he goes, I got you some shit. And he pulls out like pills and like joints. He's like, this has got gasoline in it. You're going to fucking go to the moon. I'm like, I don't want it. Of course you want it. I go, I don't want anything from you. So we're hanging out and I'm like, did you have this? He goes, I'm on 1,000 milligrams. I'm like, you're on 1,000 milligrams? He was like, yeah.
This is why I want him on that festival.
And you see like his mouth hanging open. I was like, oh my God. So we're just hanging around laughing and they're like, you know, it's the Performing Arts Center in Newark. So, you know, there's the whole staff.
Everybody's you did Newark?
Yeah. They got their earpieces in and like, they're like, and
one
like,
show or two shows?
One show.
Oh, yeah. Thank God. I did the night before you one show. Yeah. Fucking, yeah, you're a two show motherfucker. Yeah, you are. Yeah.
So
I'm looking at your touring differently.
So I go, look, they go 5 minutes, you know, 2 minutes. And then he's like, all right, we're going to go. I go, look, I go, hey, you want to go out there? I didn't go like, hey, would you, I go, you want to go out there? Want to go out there and do some time? He goes, what do you want me to do? I go, why don't you like open the show? And he goes, all right, for you, I'll do it. And I'm like, I turn to the guys and I was like, oh my God.
Do you realize if
he turns around, he starts walking to the stage. And then he's back there. He's like, what's up, dog? You know me, dog. And like doing his fucking Joey shit. Yeah. And I'm like, I go, guys, they're going to go fucking insane. And they do, you know, the house lights. All right, house lights go, house lights. House lights go down. So the crowd goes, kind of starts to cheer.
Yeah.
Dark house, music down, spotlight comes on. Joey walks into the spotlight. And you hear this go, like they go.
I saw the
video. I recorded it. I saw the video. And I sent it to you guys. And then he can't even talk. He's talking like they're just cheering so loud. And he's like, what's up, cocksuckers? I'm back. And like, and he goes, I mean, he just does his Joey thing. He's like, you come up, you'll karate chop you in the fucking neck. Just, you know, it was like we were all ear to ear smiling.
Yeah.
He's like, give it up for Tom Segura, give it up. And he's like, my brother. And then he brings up Jeff Tate, walks down. He walks up to me, he goes, I'm going to have a heart attack. I got to sit down. He sits down. He's like, Jesus Christ, it's coming out of my chest right now. Because A, is on 1,000 milligrams.
Yeah.
And B, hasn't been on a stage in like 19 months.
Yeah, he hasn't been on stage in 19 months.
And he said it took him like 10 full minutes to like come down from that.
Well, he called me at 8 a.m. the next day.
Yeah.
I answer the phone. I'm like, Joey? And he goes, I'm in, cocksucker. And I went, what? And he goes, I'm in, cocksucker. Let me know what I got to do. Just don't put me up for 40 minutes. I want to do nice, tight sets. And I was like, fucking done, Joey.
So he's in.
Done. He's in. He accepted the offer. And then I had to text everyone and be like, Joey Diaz is in. And they're like, fuck. Because now we've already have a whole full announce set up for, I mean, everyone's already seen it, to come out Wednesday for pre-sale. And then general on sale announce on Friday.
Holy shit.
And then they're like general admissions on Friday, and then all agents, managers, everyone's texting like, fucking, how did you get Joey Diaz to do it? And I was like, Tom.
No, I mean,
because you got him on, dude. When you got him, it's funny because when I saw him go on stage with you, I was jealous. I was like, God damn it. I was like, because he wasn't even returning my texts at a certain point. And so I was like, fuck. Then when I saw him on stage and I saw him, I was like, I wonder if this is going to change his mind. I go, this will be the deciding factor of whether or not he does it. I get Joey Diaz on the road in a tour bus.
Oh my God.
For 2 weeks. I cannot fucking wait. I cannot wait. I'm talking just partying. The fucking list of people, this is so selfish, because the list of people.
You have multiple buses, I hope.
We have multiple buses. Okay. We have multiple buses.
That's a big lineup for one bus.
We're going to, it's kind of a, I'm not saying that, but we're accommodating everyone. Everyone's got different accommodations. Everyone's a little different. Not everyone's me. But the fact that you get to fucking listen to Dave Attell, that I get to do majority of my act, and Dave Attell's going to watch it and go, you know how blunt he is.
Yeah.
I lose the shit about the stupid daughter. She's getting old now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Your wife sounds like a whore the way you're talking about her. You know? Yeah. Like, just that's selfish for me, is the greatest comics that I know get to watch my set and give me notes.
Yeah, notes are the best from good comics.
Yeah, but the fact that I get to spend, you know my brain. It's like not even the shows. It's like sitting in like a skybox, right?
Yeah.
You have a skybox.
Yeah.
Sitting in a skybox, having cocktails before the sun sets, watching Joey Diaz or Dave Attell. Like, that's the fucking Nikki Glaser.
I would come out. I would honestly come out to watch that show. Like, I would actually be upset.
I wanted you to do it, but I can't.
I would be upset if I had to do time, if I came to that show. Why I'd be like, I want to watch the show.
We have the, I know the dates, but like, you should come out for, you should come out for one. The problem is.
Can I just watch it?
Yeah, you can. Yeah, you can. You definitely can.
Yeah. I just want to go enjoy a show.
Yeah. I would love that. I would love that. It's going to be so much fun. Can I tell you what we're doing? Mm. I mean, we haven't announced this. I don't know if I can say this.
What?
I'm getting a mascot made of me.
It's so amazing when you deliver in such a you way, you know? Like, that is so there's gonna be a Bert mascot walking around?
Jeans, big belly, beer in one hand that never leaves.
Like with a head
with a big head and a hat.
By the way, that's a great hat you got.
And so, thank you.
Yeah.
And so, I said, we need to get this move and I need this mascot made. And they're like, well, you got to hire, this is how stupid I am. They're like, you got to hire someone to do it every day. And I was like, oh, I'm going to do it. And they're like, you're going to do it? And I was like, yeah. And they're like, well, then why don't you just not get the mascot and just walk around like yourself? And I went, oh, that's a good point. I was like, yeah, that's a good point.
No, but people would be like, oh, cool, the Bert mascot.
Yeah.
And then it would be really fucking stupid for you to take it off. Be like, it's me.
And then they're like, can you put the head back on? I want to get a picture of the mascot.
Bert and Tom, Tom and Bert. One goes topless while the other wears a shirt. Tom tells stories and Bert's the machine. There's not a chance in hell that they'll keep it clean. Here's what we call Two Bears, One Cave.